Being a researcher, you may have seen and observed many times that a particular journal basically reject your article due to the plagiarism report. So what do you think about to the plagiarism checker? Plagiarism checker basically tells, if I say in a single sentence, it checks basically the content which you have written is proper or not, or is taken from somewhere else. If you quoted the citation there, then there is no problem. But if you did not mention exact original citation in your text, then this plagiarism software tells you about the original source, whether that is a journal article or the web source or any media file. So this is the point. So what do you think about to it? By taking one example, I will show you in a systematic way that this information will be useful for both, not only the research scholars, but it will also support to the editors also. So the topic of my presentation is here: does plagiarism checker speak something to the author? Or you have a different opinion: plagiarism checker is not trustworthy. Right, so we will see it in this video. So here I have mentioned this one, a reference basically, which machine, citation machine, tells that a particular sentence is taken from this source, and that is 1% of the total words in terms of the percentage. Percentage basically is the overall words. If you are writing 3000 words article, so 2% of that, right? That means 30 into 2, 60 words are taken from a source, which basically that plagiarism checker mentioned in the report. So this is the basic idea of the percentage. So let's go further. The joint FAOWHO, this particular sentence is here. Plagiarism checker check it and mention the original source number 6 in the report. That basically number 6 is this one. This is the internet source. But what author mentioned here? Author mentioned this source, Wang et al. In 2015. Right? Author mentioned this citation. And those two basically software suggestion is mentioned here. And author citation is this particular article from this particular journal with the complete information. But what is the reason that we will discuss in the next point? Why this particular software, this plagiarism checker, providing the original source or different source from the author? Right? So you have noticed here. So let's see one by one. Author basically mentioned this particular reference, Wang C, characteristics and toxicity, assessment of airborne particulate polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons of 4 background sites in China. And this was the name of the journal, volume of the journal, and these are the page number. Journal published basically in this particular year. Originally, this was in Chinese language, but abstract was in English. If you see here, they are talking about to the particulate matters, PM2.5 and PM10 were sampled in the ambient air of 4 national background sites in the China, and all those things basically they discuss here. This article is about particulate matter, right? Originally written in Chinese language. No English version is available, which I have seen here on the internet by searching this particular journal. And now what software suggests basically about to that particular line which they mentioned. So that is the that tells this line, these lines are taken from this particular source, that is the internet source. So here again, it was from the Chinese language, originally website, when I converted it into the English, basically you can see here. And when you will read this statement, this says energizer recommended for one middle and old age, zinc, carnosine, and this citrulline. What is an energetic agent for middle age and elderly people. So in this, basically this website is referring to the energizer type of materials, nothing about to that, which was discussed in earlier slide here. Here you have seen that this is about to the particulate matter, and that is of 2.5 and 10. So this was the reference which taken by the author, and this was the suggestion by the plagiarism checker. So here you have observed that these two references are talking in a different way. One is talking about to the environment, second is talking about the energizer. When I checked it, I found that both are non-relevant references. Why I'm saying both are non-relevant references? If you see, if read it carefully, this sentence: the joint FAO-WHO expert committee on food additives, short form JECFA, conducted a comprehensive risk assessment of PAH in 2005. This recommended keeping the content of PAH in food low. First thing, you have checked here this 2005, and these are talking about to the food additives, and the reference is given here of this particular author. These authors, Wong et al. 2015. Now you can judge these about to these sentences. So which reference basically the author have to use here? When I search this statement FAO-WHO and this JECFA, I found this particular website of WHO, and I found this particular specific page for the JECFA. So you can see here joint FAO-WHO expert committee on food additives. Now I am making very clear that here that the suggestion by the plagiarism checker and the citation is considered or taken by the author, both are wrong. Instead of taking this particular citation here, author should take this original one. This is the original one, right? So here in this case, I found that both software and author are wrong. They have considered a non-relevant references for this one. So here machine as well as the author both are wrong. So the next point, and I am sure that you have taken the flavor of the idea which I want to share with you. Right, the next thing which I will share you in a short span, that is about to the introduction. If suppose you are getting plagiarism in your introduction, so what reflect, what plagiarism shows in introduction, right? So the answer is very clear that author don't know anything about to the foundation and successive progress of that particular research area if that is getting plagiarism into the introduction. And you can judge yourself also here, the this up to this one here, up to the Niger State, and this one completely plagiarism you can see here, right? And I have selected this one, these three lines, right? So you can judge that now at every sentence, right? You can see here that every sentence is basically directly taken from somewhere else, which basically this machine is telling. Now further, what is the role of mine? My role is that machine is checking properly. Author has mentioned the correct reference for that statement. So in both the cases, if one reject the article in their journal on the basis of plagiarism report instead of checking manually, that might be a wrong decision. So my request and my suggestion to both author as well as to the editor, please, first thing for the author, use only authentic and genuine reference in your article. Don't put any other reference into the article, otherwise what will happen, The machine basically will tell you about to the original source, right? Second thing, if you are not providing exact reference at the right place, then the suggestion of the machine is not 100% sure that will provide you exact result. So this information is important for the editor, and the first information was for the author. Now the responsibility to accept or reject the paper of the editor of the journal. So the decision basically will be on the basis of, is this article is checked manually or not. If this article is judged by the machine on the basis of this kind of activity, then it will be injustice with the author. So this is, again I am saying, author have to be very careful when they mention the citation, and editor have to be very careful when they take the decision on any paper on the basis of any plagiarism report. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any question, you can ask. And I can say only at the end, please use authentic and genuine references in your article.